Thunder Tier 1 is a tactical top-down shooter by Krafton, where the realism of a modern military sim is fused with the stylings of a twin-stick arcade game. You take control of a single soldier, but operate within a four-man squad known as Thunder 1. Your squad mates can be controlled by other players or AI. Your team is sent to rein in the terrorist activity of an unhinged group of proto-nationalists known as the SBR. The game doesn't emphasize narrative. Though your squad mates will have country flags by their call signs, they're all wearing distinctly American-styled camo. It's best not to think too hard about what's going on. The mission briefs hit just the right amount of military jargon to let you know where to shoot. You're free to customize the look of your character, but that's all the personality they get. The campaign is a string of 9 missions that just barely feel connected to one another. Its objectives gradually increase in complexity with mid-mission shakeups that are a mild surprise the first time through. Scenarios always begin with infiltration and range from securing documents or personnel to destroying weapon caches and clearing locations of all hostiles. These tried and true situations give you ample opportunity to experiment with your gear and weapons. Your team will be loaded up with breach charges, claymore mines, magazines, grenades, wire cutters, and anything else you might think you'll need for a successful mission. Having to fumble in the inventory and fit gear in the grid-like slots feels deliberately designed. The game goes to great lengths to try and replicate the hurdles that come with not just cumbersome gear, but also urban combat, which adds tension to mid-firefight inventory management. Visibility on the map is based on the squad's line of sight. If someone can't directly see an enemy, they're literally invisible in the surrounding area. A glimpse of an enemy will leave a red-outlined last known location, but visual cues like rippling sound waves and objects being knocked over are a brilliant way to show what your team can hear and are equally useful in pinpointing threats. The metagame of confirming enemy locations elevates the twin-stick combat into something that feels far more tactical. Movement is slow and methodical, while firing is twitchy, but making good use of your equipment to get the drop on enemies or to patch up hurt allies while pinned down makes combat and missions feel dynamic and thrilling. The AI of your team and enemies can sometimes break the illusion of your tactical prowess, however. When playing solo, you can issue several orders to your squad, like making them take cover, suppress specific areas, or take context-sensitive orders like breaching doors. But they can easily get stuck on geometry, or crawl away from other squadmates when wounded, to die in secret like a cat. Meanwhile, enemy AI struggles to find doors, or stares you in the face waiting to be shot. But gameplay remains entertaining despite these hiccups. PvE and PvP servers are available and are likely the biggest draw for this tactical sandbox. The goal-oriented team dynamics are where Thunder Tier 1 shines, and they make it easy to host public or private servers to invite friends to do any of the campaign missions with you, or complete objectives against another human squad. I was also impressed with the level of detail packed into maps. Aside from some occasional wonky physics, the game performed well, even with lots of carnage happening on screen. Thunder Tier 1 feels like it's made to scratch a very specific itch. If you have a love for modern military gear and tactical combat scenarios, you'll feel at home. But the thrown-together campaign and the PvP servers may not cater to a more casual fan. Thunder Tier 1 is out now for $19.99 on PC.